The invasion of Ukraine has put things in perspective and shown us what's really important, having a go at people who voted differently to us in a referendum 6 years ago. This war has made wokery irrelevant. We should stop using words like chairperson and go back to things like chairman or chairwoman. But let's be honest, chairman. We should call cities by their proper names. Peking, not Beijing. Paris, not Paris. Verulamium, not St. Albans. We are living in a serious world, and I am a serious girl. Who even remembers now that the Prime Minister repeatedly broke rules that he set up during a public health crisis he was mismanaging? It's just trivial fluff, which was actually my nickname at school. It's like I said to my wife, yes, I might have had an affair, but your mother's in hospital, so let's get some perspective here. The invasion of Ukraine is very much like Brexit, in that Vladimir Putin wanted both of them to happen, and they've both gone exactly to plan. Labour would wave the white flag for Putin, whereas we'd get the white powder out and share it with his buddies. We in the Conservative Party believe in freedom. Not freedom from poverty, or freedom from ill health, or freedom from fear of the police, but the freedom to exploit your workers, the freedom to undermine democracy, and most importantly of all, the freedom to piss off your friends and allies to make a cheap political point. The British people voted in large numbers to leave the EU, not because they dislike foreigners, but because they believe in freedom. And also because quite a lot of them dislike foreigners. Putin has spent over 20 years lying to his people about the West. What an amateur. We've spent over 30 years lying to our people about the EU. I've taken a moment of unity and common purpose, and I've polarised it. If I was Churchill, I'd have said, "Some of us will fight them on the beaches. I think we all know who I'm talking about." The privet hedges of suburbia are the privet hedges of a free people, whereas I find that the hedges in cities are often filled with takeaway containers and the remnants of ethnic food. Sorry, is this dog whistle loud enough? We have to keep our immigration checks in place because we all know that a small number of people can cause utter havoc in a country. But enough about the cabinet, we also have to look out for those Russian children. Don't believe children are a threat? Well, let me introduce you to a little documentary I've seen called Spy Kids. I mean, we've been in power for 12 years. We've got to do something good eventually, right? Well, that'll definitely rile up a few people on Twitter. Job done.